Hi everyone, Grant for the Flame Learning Channel. In the previous videos, you learnt about the various frame ranges, as well as sorting the order of the storyboard thumbnails. So you can display the storyboard in the order of the edit. You could sort the storyboard reel by tape name and source timecode. Or finally, you could sort the thumbnails by record timecode. So essentially, this helps you speed up various creative tasks through ordering the storyboard reel. Now this is a useful functionality to have, but the effects environment also has additional filtering and searching capabilities. So instead of just reordering all the shots, you can lock down on specific ones. This video is not footage specific, so you can use your own media to follow along. Now when you enter the effects environment, normally the storyboard reel will show you all your shots, whether you're using the track, sources, or version sort modes. This is regardless of the viewport settings or the time bar range. Now let's say that you only want to focus on the current selection, and absolutely nothing else matters. So to filter based on selection, just click the filter button. You could map this button to the keyboard through the keyboard shortcuts editor. So you only have one shot to work on, and you won't accidentally affect any of the other segments in the edit. You could even press Alt F1 to hide the storyboard reel if you want. The same keyboard shortcut will bring it back. Disable the filter button to bring back all the other thumbnails. Taking this another step forward, let's say you want to filter multiple shots. So the first selection you make is your current selection, and that has the yellow highlight. To add to the selection, just use Shift to select a contiguous range or Control to select various clips along the storyboard. All secondary selections will always have an orange highlight. When you activate the filter button again, only the thumbnails in the selection will be displayed. You can use filtering on top of any of the three sorting modes. But once filtering is on, the sorting modes are grayed out because these clips cannot be sorted anymore at this point. Turning off filtering will re-enable the sorting modes again. Now with filtering enabled, you are only looking at your selection. You can still navigate between the selected thumbnails by clicking on them or using the player controls and keyboard shortcuts. But the selection won't be released with filtering on. You can also choose what to see in the time bar. Click the options pull-down menu, and you can choose segment or media range for just the current selection, or you can choose storyboard range. Timeline range is not available when the filter is enabled. So the time bar can scrub or play across all the shots. Just remember that if you use the storyboard range, you also need to go to the viewport viewing menu and set the context to storyboard context. You can toggle the 4 keyboard shortcut to do the same. Now I mentioned earlier that the filtering works on selections. You select your clips and apply the filter. However, you need to know that you can't add or remove from an existing selection while filtering is enabled. To do that, you would need to disable the filtering and adjust your selection. So you can sort the storyboard thumbnails using the sorting modes, and you can filter the storyboard down using selections. The third means of refining the storyboard is to perform a search. Click the search icon, and you will get the same search options as the main timeline search tools. Now you can manually enter in all your search requirements, or you can get the information from the current selected segment. For example, I want to isolate all the shots based on the tape name. So you enable the tape option as a search criteria and disable any other options you don't want in the search. Click Select. All the shots with the matching data will be selected. And since this is a selection, you enable the filter button and only the selection will be displayed in the storyboard reel. you can then start working on these shots. Now, what's very important to know about the search function is that it adds to the current selected segment. In other words, if you are going to search the storyboard, make sure that one of the search clips is already the current selection. Otherwise, you'll land up with one wrong clip in the selection after the search. Now, one final tip is if you go back into the search window, you can search by marker or segment marker. What this means is if you used markers to identify specific segments in the edit, the search tool will select those shots under the markers. So this can be useful in certain scenarios. Just bear in mind that search by markers in the main timeline search tool will select the markers and not the segments like you have in the effects environment. So in conclusion, you can apply filtering based on an explicit selection, or you can apply filtering based on a search of the clip's properties. Please remember that sorting, filtering, and searching are all temporary organizing tools to help focus the storyboard, and your main edit remains unaffected when you go back to the timeline view. Now, before we move on to the new player options in the effects environment, the next short video will cover an alternative way to display the storyboard, which can help you better manage the interface and use the storyboard in a more creative way. Don't forget to check out the other features, workflows, and enhancements to Flame 2019. Comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Please subscribe to the Flame Learning channel for future videos, and thanks for watching.